Welcome to our OÖ guided tour here at the OK for the exhibition Weltmaschine. This exhibition is set up in four different scenes and explores the many ways in which science has inspired artists, but also tries to shed light onto different aspects of science that have been inspired by art and science fiction. It is actually an homage to Johannes Kepler, whose 450th birthday we celebrated last December, and who also lived in Linz for quite some time.
Follow me.
So the first scene is dedicated to Kepler, who is so famously known for describing the principles of planetary motion. Even though he himself was a deeply devout man, he also believed that the principles of the universe are those of an unbelievably complex machine that can be understood rather than the will of a mythical almighty God. So Kepler was fascinated by the regularities of the Platonic bodies and even tried to use them to describe the principles of planetary motion, as you can see in this famously known picture from his Mysterium Cosmographicum. This is actually an example of how even great minds might get it wrong the first time, because he found the actual principles of planetary motion some years ago. In this work, the Hungarian artist Churchill picked up the fascination for the Platonic bodies and translated them into this machine that converts an icosaeder into three other Platonic bodies, namely a pyramid, a cube, and an octahedron. Others like Sigmund Polke had a more ironic approach to these themes and wanted to satirize the kinetic art of many of his contemporaries, and constructed this machine in which a potato moves around another potato. Also Kepler himself wrote fiction after what he called a delirious dream, in which he fantasized about life on the moon. Here, Benjamin Prestel invited visitors to fantasize about different planets by the use of a planetomat and planetotape. The calculating space, by Ralf Becker, is an intricately woven system of strings and weights, which always strives to find some way of equilibrium. The moving part will set in motion a cascade of events to restore balance within the system. This space can be seen as an analogy for space itself, which is, like Kepler put it, a system that follows comprehensible laws. Second scene is dedicated to time-traveling wormholes and faster than light speed. You can see artwork that will let you sink into a wormhole like the lobby of Bertrand Lamarche, and also show great minds like Werner Heisenberg failing at constructing a world formula, only demonstrating the longing of probably most humans for some holistic, all-explaining thing. Other great scientists have been inspired by more profane things, like the series Star Trek, to brainstorm on whether time traveling or faster than light speed might theoretically ever work. The next scene explores the really little things. In Dark Gravity, for example, Helga Griffiths lets us visit a 3D reconstruction of her own brain, while it also permits you to see one of the first microscopes constructed by Antoni von Leeuwenhoek. Right next to it is the central element of a tunnel microscope, which is used by scientists to make single atoms visible. And another marvel that you can wonder at is the nano car. It has no motor and was actually a byproduct in 2005 of the very freaky research questions how fullerenes move about. In 2017, there are actually nano car races. An Austro-American team even won the silver surface track with the mind-blowing speed of 95 nanometers per hour. The fourth and last scene is dedicated to how nature inspires artists and scientists alike. I will let you explore this last room for yourself on your next visit to the OK. So this is an exhibition for everyone. And after your visit, our new museum in the box is waiting to be explored.